Tubers, and welcome to Big Buddha's Getting Bigger. I'm Big Buddha, and this is just going to be a little mini getting bigger now. Not all of these videos are strictly speaking recipe videos. Some of these ones are just really what I like to call the correct way to eat stuff. Okay, and today I'm going to be looking at the correct way to eat some of my favorite childhood sweets. I was very particular when it came to sweets and chocolates growing up, as you'll see in probably in some future videos, because I always believed there was a correct way to eat them, and indeed an incorrect way to eat them for anyone else. So here I'm going to show you how to eat these. These are sports mixtures. They're kind of like a harder version of wine gums. And I've got 100 grams here. I wish I got 150 grams, but I got these from Ye Olde Sweet Shop, which is the only way to get these old-fashioned sweets now. It used to be standard, in every newsagent's behind the counter, the big jars of sweets, plastic tubs, and you'd go in and ask for 150 grams worth, whatever. Now it's you have to seek out these specialist sweet shops, and not all of them have them, but the chain of Ye Olde Sweet Shops has them. So it's a combination of sports mixture and these sherbet fountains. Anyone over the age of 50 might remember these. So they used to come in cardboard tubes. Now they're in hard-boiled plastic ones with a bit of, and it was a real bit of licorice sticking out of the top, which you could just pull straight out. The idea was you'd lick the end, dip that in, and it was like cocaine for kids. So it's just a combination of sherbet fountains and sports mixture, and it's absolutely lovely. Let's see how we do it.
First, arrange the sports mixture into colours, with the most amount of colours on the right and the least on the left. Then, take the highest amount of one colour, in this case the black. For those watching in black and white, they're the ones next to the red. Take a glass of water and marinate the black sports mixture. Unwrap the sherbet fountain. Remove the licorice and consume. Pour two sherbet fountains into a small bowl. Then take your sports mixture, starting with the smallest color first, dip in the water, then the sherbet, and consume.
Okay, I've just added those sports mixture mixed with the sherbet. Well, most of it. All that remains is the best part now, is the black sports mixture, which has been left to soak for about 10 minutes now. So it's gone all sort of slimy and it's got a sort of jammy overcoat on the side. So it just remains to get rid of the water. That's like a palate cleanser. And then with the remaining sports mixture, we add that to the remaining sherbet. Oh, it's kind of like glue. It's I can actually get them out of the glass. And then finally, we mix the remaining marinated sports mixture into the sherbet. And we eat them all together. Yeah, so the slimy jam exterior, it mixes and fizzes with the sherbet. Sorry, talking with my mouth full. The black ones are slightly different from the wine gums. They are licorice-y flavour, so you get that added. A bit there, but I think that goes really well together. A lovely childhood favourite. So, leave me to reminisce with my memories.